in the extraction of calcium from its calcium chloride, it doesn't mean that calcium chloride is the only ore of calcium. We have so many ores of calcium, like the dolomite. Okay, but here the ore that is used in the extraction of calcium here is calcium chloride, and the cathode is, we are using iron. Iron is the cathode, and the anode is still graphite. And in this extraction, calcium fluoride is used to reduce the melting point of calcium chloride from 850 degrees Celsius to 650 degrees Celsius. The essence of this reduction in the melting point is to avoid the loss of calcium in the course of extraction. So there is something spectacular that is very important in this electrolytic process. That is the migration of ions. Okay, we have calcium here. Calcium will definitely migrate to the cathode, which is the negative electrode, in order to gain back the electrons it has lost when they were in fused state. So when this happens, calcium is gaining back the electrons in order to be a calcium metal, a free metal that is going to be extracted. Okay, so look at what happens here. Calcium was calcium. The anode, what happens? Chlorine, which was negatively charged in the fused state, we go back to the positive anode in order to give back the electrons it has accepted when they were in fused state. So chlorine is going to lose the electron, be chlorine atom, or in order to form chlorine molecule. And if you check with me, you will see that chlorine here to be chlorine plus E, and when we join chlorine, chlorine molecule. And you will agree with me that since chlorine has lost the electrons, means that reduction has occurred here. Reduction has occurred here. So calcium is produced at the cathode, while chlorine gas is produced at the anode. For watching, bye for now.